Hey guys, it's Miss Hoyt from SISU coming to you on this wonderful Friday, doing our character rally for the month of May with resilience from SISU. You guys talked with Miss Barnes and Fauna last month about perseverance, and perseverance and resilience kind of go together. In order to persevere in things, we have to have resilience. We have to deal with that frustration and know that in the end that I can do it. It might take me a little bit, but I can do it. So SISU and I have prepared a presentation for you, so I'm going to share my screen with you guys so that you can see. And we're going to be talking about some resilience today. And we are going to start with this PowerPoint presentation on resilience. Now, I want you to be thinking about something of how you can deal, think about how you can deal with resilience. Now, that's that frustration we feel that when we're doing a math problem and we just can't get it right and we want to give up. Resilience is not giving up, is learning and keep going. So resilience is all things are difficult before they are easy. So that math problem that you're struggling with and the beginning is really hard. And the more you do them, the more you practice. And the more that you're practicing, the easier they become because you're learning. If everything was easy, we wouldn't really be learning much, would we? So the more time it takes, the better it is. We're learning more and the more we are learning. That is resilience. It's that frustration level, but we keep going. So we're going to build our character and learn more about our character and how resilience affects us and how we can deal with resilience.
Have you ever had the feeling that even though you're trying really hard to do something, you just can't do it? Being resilient means that you have the skills to keep trying and never give up, even when things get tough. When you're stuck, parts of your character work together to help you figure things out. Here's determination, who keeps you going, even when you want to give up. And let's say hello to concentration, who allows you to keep focused on the task in hand. And learning, who makes sure that when you do master something, that you can keep doing it again and again. By working on any one of these parts of your character, you'll start to improve your resilience. And eventually you'll find that you're able to keep your cool and work through difficulties, even when the pressure mounts.
So having that resilience is taking a second and saying, okay, I can do this. I just need to keep practicing and being focused and on task will help you to learn resilience, not getting upset. When you saw in that video where he was starting to get upset and he threw down the little toy that he was playing with, we don't want you to get upset. We want you to focus and breathe and keep going. We have a message from all of our SISU members for you with our favorite quotes about resilience.
Hi guys, this is Miss Nolan, and my favorite quote about resilience is actually a Japanese proverb, and it's fall down seven times, stand up eight. And what it essentially means is choosing to never give up and always keep striving. And when you do that, you will embody that SISU spirit of resilience.
It always seems impossible until it's done. Nelson Mandela.
The very things that hold you down are going to lift you up. Las mismas cosas que te detienen, que son difíciles, te levantarán.
Every great dream begins with a dreamer. Always remember you have the strength, the patience, and the passion to reach for the stars to change the world. I miss you. Mwah.
Babe Ruth said, every strike brings me closer to a home run. In these challenging times, SISU wants you to show your resilience and just keep on swinging.
Hi, everyone. Nelson Mandela was quoted as saying, the greatest glory in living lies not in never failing, but in rising every time we fail.
As Margaret Thatcher said, you may have to fight a battle more than once to win it.
The very things that are going to bring you down are going to lift you up. By Timothy Mouse from Dumbo.
Our greatest weakness lies in giving up. The most certain way to succeed is always to try just one more time. Thomas Edison.
We gain strength and courage and confidence by each experience in which we really stop to look fear in the face. We must do that which we think we cannot. Eleanor Roosevelt.
So looking resilient straight in the eye and saying, I can do this. I don't need anything. I can do it. I can bounce back and I can accomplish the goal that I want. So thinking about something about resilience in a moment and what makes you be able to bounce back. Maybe it's taking a minute and breathing, or maybe it's just taking a break from something. Miss Lamb, while you guys think about that, Miss Lamb is going to read you guys a story about resilience.
Hi, boys and girls. This is Miss Lamb, and I'm so excited that you're joining us for our SISU Character Rally all about resilience. So now I'm going to read a book to you called Bounce Back, A Book About Resilience by Sherry Miners, illustrated by Elizabeth Allen. So let's get started. Bounce Back. I'm learning to take care of myself and to solve my own problems. Hard things can happen to anyone at any time. My problem might seem really big. I may feel lots of things at once. I'm moving. The way I think about my problem can affect how I feel about it. I might feel sad, hurt, or worried. I'll never see her again. Why is she leaving? Who will I play with? I can choose what I think about. I want to stay calm and understand what is happening. Where are you moving? Not far away. I might feel better if I think about my problem in a new way. Finding the good in what happens can help me bounce back. Maybe I can visit you. I don't know why some things happen, but I can find ways to be strong. I can bounce back. I can let little things go. Other people are trying their best. I won't blame them. It's okay. I have strength inside me to do things on my own and to try something I've never done. I can bounce back when I make a mistake. I can admit it and try to fix it. It was my idea. Sorry. Sometimes I can't change my problem, but I can change what I think or do about it. I might learn to be more brave, patient, or caring. Things don't always stay the same. I can remember happy times and also enjoy right now. Looking forward to something gives me hope and helps me get through a hard time. Many people believe in me. I feel better when I'm around them. There is always something to feel glad about. I can talk and listen and get help from people I look up to and trust. I can reach out to someone. When I care about other people more, I worry less about my own problems. I'm learning to be the very best me. When something is hard for me, it may be just what I need to grow. I can decide to bounce back. And that's the end of our book about resilience. Thank you so much for listening, and I can't wait to see you soon.
So being able to bounce back and have that resilience and being able to focus our attention on something else for a little bit and then maybe going back to that, it kind of helps sometimes. Elmo is dealing with frustration and learning how to do something that he's not quite mastered. A lot of us have dealt with that feeling and situation, and we might not be able to do it yet, but we can. And we will get there, just not at this moment, but we will. Stay tuned.
Oh, oh boy, time for bed. I'm almost ready for his bedtime story. Just as soon as he can button these pajamas. Oh, come on. Why isn't this working? Oh, Daddy! Daddy! Daddy!
What is it, son? What's the matter?
It's the buttons on these PJs.
What about them?
They're too hard. Elmo tried and tried to button them, but it's just not working. Boy, Elmo's just so...
Frustrated?
Yes. Yes, Elmo is very frustrated because Elmo can't do buttons.
Yet.
What's that?
You can't do the buttons yet. But one day you will.
No, No, Emma would never be able to.
Oh, son, I know it feels that way, but that's because you're so frustrated. You gotta keep trying and not give up.
Yeah, but Daddy, why shouldn't Emma give up?
Well, because the more you try and practice, the better you'll be. Well, that goes for just about anything. Here. Oh, look at this.
Yeah?
There was a time when you didn't know how to draw or write your own name very well yet. But now you can, can't you?
Well, yeah.
Because you kept trying and practicing and you got better at it, right?
Well, yeah. Well, Emma draws a lot better now and can write his own name.
Okay, well, that's something to keep in mind when you have trouble doing something else. You may not be able to do it yet, but you'll be able to do it someday. You'll figure it out.
And that's what SISU wants you guys to understand. We want you to figure it out. We want you to keep trying. We want you to make those mistakes. So the distance between us may seem far, but we can come together in this challenge and show each other how resilient we are. You've seen these challenge boards before. We did them in the classrooms with all the other character traits. And you did them with your teachers. Now SISU is challenging you to do it at home and focus on resilience. So a couple things that you guys can do. Everyone in my family shared a goal that they have. Everybody has a goal, whether it be a little goal or a big goal. Share it. Talk about it. Someone in my family made a mistake and learned from it. Guys, we make mistakes all the time. That's how we learn. That's what helps our resilience grow. And that's how we become better, is making the mistakes and learn from them. Make lots of them. Good mistakes, but make them and learn from them. Someone in my family tried something new. We are trying lots of new things right now in our world. So talking about those new things that we're trying. And in the beginning, a lot of these new things are not easy. They're really hard, but we can try them and keep trying until we can do it. Someone in my family kindly encouraged another classmate not to give up. So telling people to keep going and encouraging. At least one person in my family can explain why a growth mindset is important. Knowing that we can do something later. We might not be able to do it now, but we can. We will get there. Think about riding your bike. You really want that big kid bike. But in order to get that big kid bike, you guys have to learn how to balance on a bike. You guys have to learn how to pedal on a bike with the training wheels. And before those training wheels can get off, you have to keep practicing and practicing. That's resilience. It's saying, okay, this is really hard and I keep falling and I can't get this right and I can't balance, but you will. You will get there. You can't ride a big kid bike yet, but you will. Or doing that math problem, understanding that I can solve a problem one way, but maybe not another way. Maybe I can try that strategy another time. So knowing that I can do it this way and I eventually will understand it, the more I practice, the better we become at things. That is resilience. So our closing song is from Zootopia, if you are not familiar with Zootopia. The bunny in this video is trying to be a police officer, and in her world, bunnies don't become police officers. She faces a lot of trials and tribulations. She wants to give up. She gets very frustrated with herself, but she doesn't. She's able to be successful, and she tries hard every day. We want you to try things every day and make mistakes. Enjoy.
I messed up tonight. I lost another fight. Lost to myself, but I'll just start again. I keep falling down. I keep on hitting the ground. I always get enough to see what's next. Birds don't just fly, they fall down and get up. Nobody learns without getting it wrong. I won't give up, no, I won't give in until I reach the end, and then I'll start again. No, I won't leave. I wanna try everything, I wanna try even though I could fail. I won't give up.
That is our presentation. I'm going to stop sharing my screen so that I can see you and you can see me. So SISU wants you guys to know a few things. We want you to make mistakes. We want you to learn from them. We want you to keep trying. We don't want you to give up. We don't want you to feel frustrated. We want you to take a break, to figure it out, to say, okay, I can do it. I might be able to do it yet, but I will, and I will get there, and I'm going to make lots of new mistakes, and I'm going to keep learning, and I'm going to keep pushing myself, because that is resilience, guys. We miss you all. We love you all. We hope you all do well. We hope you have a great rest of your weekend and a rest of your Friday, and we can't wait to see you guys again. This is SISU out. Bye, guys.